We have reached 1998, and right knowledge is reaching people all over the world. The Supreme Grandmaster Naya Malachi Zedakios El is truly setting the record straight. Now listen to these facts, the voice of truth in these last days and times. The Nuwakian Nation of Moors brings you the man of the hour.
Women were created first. Women are our God.
They know better than God.
But that's not the Bible said. The Bible was written by a man. You think he's going to write about this? The whole first book, the whole first chapter of the Bible only deals with one woman, Eve, and she deceived the man. So that's the first thing a woman does in the Bible is deceive somebody. The very first thing. Who wrote that Bible? What a man of God wrote that Bible. Men don't hate women that much to make them such monsters. King James was bona fide sugar. And his whole thing was to beat down the woman. Read the Bible. You got right off, you start off with Eve betraying her husband by the hand of the hand out of the servant's door. Good. Next thing we get down as far as women's problems, we get all the way down to Abraham. Sarah can't have a baby, so she gives her maid servant to Abraham, right? And then after she finds out she can have a baby, then she throws the other woman out. That's how women deal with her. That ain't nice. No man wants to think y'all think like that. But a man is not interested in women, but they want to keep us being women. Keep women down. Keep women always trying to get over, trying to see, trying to be equal, trying to be treated fair, makes y'all a monster. In a society where the records have already been written that y'all are being serious. And when someone comes along like me and says, I did a little research and I found out women are not being serious. Women are the superior. They are the God. They said, what in my Bible? They said, huh? Did you say what? Now some things are here. Until you bring a Bible of truth, a Bible that matches up with scientific data, facts, because God would know. I mean, what? God would know, because when God looks at male and female, God looks beyond the skin, the flesh, and he can look down into the chromosomes and the genes, in the DNA and the RNA and the X's and the Y's. God can see that far, can he not? So hell, when God sees a man walking, and he sees an X and Y chromosome, and he sees a woman walking, and he sees two X chromosomes. Doesn't God know that Y is limbless? That one of the limbs on it is broken? If you can take an X and Y chromosome, an X and X, and lay it on top of it, and the X and Y can merge into the X and X, but if you go the other way, it don't happen? Wouldn't God see that? Wouldn't God know what mitochondrial DNA is? Wouldn't God know what the ball of land is? Wouldn't he know that women were men, and men were women in the womb? And that women have prostate glands like men did? And that women have penises like men did? And that everything came from her? She has everything we have, not yet. And we have things that she doesn't have? No. We have things that she has that she uses, and we got it done. Start again. We got things in our body, and on our body. You know what I'm saying? Women got things on their body that we got on our body that they use that we don't. Explain that. You don't breast feed me, but you have breasts called tits. But this woman here has breasts that are children, right? Why is it that we have breasts of no use? And the sole purpose of breast is to produce a manual fluid for nourishment and breastfeeding the young, because it's hell. Who must have been first? If all animals depend on the breast milk for sustenance, how could we have been here first without having seen the breast milk? And any doctor will tell you, if you investigate what is in a woman's breast milk, every nutrient, vitamin, pure water, everything that makes you intelligent. People that have not been breastfed is improving. They're not as smart as people who've been breastfed. They're not as calm. They're not as healthy. Now you know why I was standing here like this. That's what I breastfed. And you know nothing was breastfed. That nigga walks around with you, and when you say anything, they keep going, huh? You know the guy? The guy will get downstairs, and then he says, where's the seat for the dog? You tell me to get the seat. How come we gonna get one of them out of the seat for the dog? Are you picking on me? You know the guy? Well, see, that guy didn't get breastfed. Now, some of y'all are looking at me with a very serious look in your face, and I understand, or I take that as you probably didn't get breastfed.
Come home and jump back to do the same thing again? And some of them get the same thing.
pregnant. Remember all you men who've been around when women deliver. What it looked like. What they were going through. Remember the expressions on their face. And when we saw them squeeze something into the blood that they had. And their hair was white. And you remember this. I'm going through with this baby with you. You have it, but something triggers in them to say, do it again. Plenty of men would do that twice. I want to go to the next thing. How many men would do that and only once? Say, brother man.
Yeah, Pop, in the book, the child said, but he said something about the female being a hybrid off the male. Now, what do you mean by it? Because that kind of confuses me when you think that, and then you can't express as far as the...
We're speaking from the male gender, female gender, religious speaking. When you go from the religion, whether it's Islam, Christianity, Judaism, and that's the school we're in at that time. Now, we ain't looking at Egypt, we ain't looking at Samaria. We're looking back at Bible, Quran, Torah. Women came from that. Women are hybrid of men. Now, that's giving you what you want. So you learn to want what I have to give. Now let me tell you the real deal. As a man, it hurt me, it hurt me to do it to face the reality that that's my God sitting there. But it's a reality that we got to confront and we got to face, because scientific evidence is going to prove everybody in the religious community wrong, because they didn't anticipate a computer. They didn't anticipate the role of it. And research. That wasn't any agenda when the Bibles were being written. When the Quran was being written. They know put the Bible and the Quran in a computer and analyze it word for word and see all the scientific errors there. They didn't know that was happening. Everything was done back then by word of mouth. A great scholar said that he taught or he learned from some pre-written books. And no one was able to say exactly what does that word mean and where did it come from. That was all part of reaching people. When you come to a people, and that people have been programmed to believe in the doctrine that the brother said, me, Lord Jesus Christ, my brother said, your heart, mother, what thou has no father. When they're programmed, if you go against that grain, you're a bad person. Before they even think about listening to you. Then you cannot even get into their house to relate to them. If I came from a Muslim family today, let me tell you something. Allah is a female, the feminine is Allah. What would they say? Fuck Allah, he won't be the man to take off my hair. Get out of my house. So, you got one thing about our people, but they're so easy turned against you. Remember? You got to come in and sit down with them. That's why they said Master Prophet Muhammad came inside amongst them and ate with them. That's the methodology to get inside people and talk to them. If all that,
the woman's body, mitochondria DNA, which predates man by a thousand years, when woman was God, woman's body has a defense mechanism in it. Do we agree?
Yes.
Like a man's body. No, someone's there. Well, if you take alien blood from anybody, I'll make it clear, and inject it into a woman, in 6 to 8 weeks, her blood will overthrow that alien blood. That's why they have to be very careful with transfusions if they get people who have the same type of blood. Because your body will reject it. Now, transplanting organs has proven that to be a fact. That if they give you someone else's heart, the problem is always what? Rejection. Why does it reject it? Because your body has a built-in mechanism for it to defend itself against alien properties of all kinds. All right, so then, if a man and a woman are together, sexually that is, when a man releases semen into the woman, it's what? It's alien to her. What is the first thing her body thinks to do? Protect. But they found out, scientists, that there's a certain part of the brain that triggers and it releases a serum that creates an egg inside the womb of the mother. It's an egg or a bag, a pouch. You follow that? And the baby or the fetal is in this bag. And it's kept in a lubricant of water that is producing the hormone, so that it is actually fighting against her invading the baby and killing it. When the brain does not trigger this properly, you hear me? And it doesn't send enough of these defense mechanisms, there's a miscarriage. Right? If too many of these things get in the bloodstream and into the baby. When the baby is born, within 6 to 8 weeks, there's cradle death. It still attacks the baby. They'll tell you they don't know what cradle death is, because they don't know. But it's a scientific fact. So now, what actually happens is, the baby in the womb of the human female as a mammal is living in a sack of water. Has anybody here been raised on farms? I mean, you see a hen lay an egg, right? Does it come out hard or soft? A lot of city folk might not know that. When a hen lays an egg, it's soft. You follow? And then when it hits the air, it begins to harden. The same thing happens with the placenta of the woman. When they first remove it from the woman, it's soft. In just a couple of minutes, it starts to harden up, the clock. What am I reaching at? I'm reaching at the fact that women have an egg inside of them. Did they really give birth to an egg? But unlike the chickadee, it cracks the shell on the outside of the body. You call it my water breaking. And the egg breaks inside and the baby comes forth. And sometimes they'll say the egg collapsed and put a thin veil over the baby's face. And let's say the medieval doctors, who didn't quite understand what that meant, said that baby was born with a seventh veil. Had a veil over his face. That's a mystical baby. He's going to be psychic or clairvoyant or something. That passed all the way down to grandma, saying seventh kid has a seventh veil on his face. All that was the shell of the egg collapsing. What are we saying here? We're saying that human beings are a form of mammal that has an egg inside, and the baby is developed in a liquid substance, so thus the baby is breathing with gills and does not inherit its lungs until it comes. And sometimes in the hospital, they have to pump water out of the baby's lungs, showing that it's just like the movie of The Abyss.
Yahuli, when the yard was put against it for the head,
and became master, became Yahuwah. They shifted the gradually moved the female goddess out, and men came in, and then we became God when she was God. She was the mother. She ruled. Mother and matter is the exact same word. And the word mat and the word man is in heretics and ta for earth. Mat and ta. Mat means divine justice. And ta is the planet, earth. Right? You follow that? Mother and matter are all the same words. You say remove the pylon, which is the M, and you get the other being. You understand? That was the woman. She is God. We are her children. About that, she was first. She had all the brains. It was concentrated effort by religious dogma that removed the woman's brain surgically to give her an inferiority complex and to step down by removing the term mother and adding the word wife. And as you go through all the Semitic languages, the word for wife is left, there's no such word for wife. They use the word Imra'a from the word Mara'a, from the word Amir, meaning ruler, or they use the word Zoe, which means copy or duplicate. And it's a masculine word, there's no feminine. So the male is a copy or a duplicate. There's no word for wife. And the word for mother was Um, which is own. You know what I'm saying? Women are the gods. We may not like this man, you got this male chauvinist complex. They are the gods. And we have got to recognize our women for what she is and come down on this male chauvinist stuff because we don't know what we're doing. She, as a mother, knows how to run the house. Right? Knows how to say she's got it in her nature. We don't. And the first group of people that's wise enough to make the woman the God and make the woman the ruler are going to be the most successful people on the planet. As long as men are ruling, there's going to be chaos because the conflict is always men against men. Ain't no woman in the Nation of Islam spoke out against Allah Muhammad until the men did. It's men that are jealous of men. So if women were ruling, then they would pick and choose who they want. You see that, brother? You see that, sister? That's why men don't want you to rule. Because if you rule as a power of unquestionable authority, you might not pick that nigga. You know what I'm saying? If you had your choice, and I ain't gonna put nobody on the spot, if you had your choice, you might not be sitting next to that nigga there. You might have chose something better. Well, so men are gonna keep control. But as long as we keep control, we make the choices. That's the greatest fear. Women today are still having children without men. It's about that. They have virgin conception without men. Women's glands can produce the serum that she can have a child without a man. Now, this is a fact. Go look it up. Parthenogenesis, that's what it's called. Parthenogenesis. Look it up. It's about how women can have children without men. They'll start off by just saying how, virgin birth. But then don't stop there. Keep probing. And you'll find out the women don't need them.
Name one black female leader today with an agenda. What happened? I'll tell you what happened. In the 60s, when all that Afro and culture woke up, concentrated effort came in to make you Bobby Doll again. Now look at the video. Everybody knows that Bobby Doll. Wigs and tight shirts and splits and shaking their ass all over the place. They removed all the comfort and football from the 60s all into the 70s. And now our women are gone and dead again. So of course there's no female black agenda. There's no female in black no more. Y'all need leadership. Y'all need organization amongst yourselves. Y'all need purpose. Y'all need direction. Y'all need guidance. Black women. Come on out here sometime without us, man. Have your own meeting, maybe around that stack of ice and y'all sit down and start talking to me about a female gender.
Don't shy for putting a woman out front. And let her take her position as the mother of the universe. Don't punk under that macho crap, because it didn't work for 25,000 years. It didn't. We messed it up. So now let's let the woman do something. They'll have a place as a mother. A mother knows how to take care of her children. Ain't a man in here that can do without a woman. And before you got the woman that you lean head to head to right there, you had another woman who you leaned on call your mother. Right? What man did not love a woman from the day they were born? Is there any man that didn't love their mother? Now you love your wife. Correct? Or we hope so. She nurtured you. Not he, she. You passed through the canal through her. Not he, through her. She is the genetic code, Mother Ninty. And there's no religion that gets away from her. In Islam, they're giving praise to Fatima. Christianity, they're giving praise to Mary. Judaism, they're giving praise to Dinah, the only 13th tribe of Israel. Nobody gets away from her. Let us men, let us be the first group to push our women to the top. You know what? You will baffle the world. You will baffle the world when you start getting out the car and running around and open the door for her. When you reach in and grab her hand and help her down. While y'all got on sweatpants and sneakers and only gonna stop off at a donut shop. Let people look and go, what the heck is that? When we have in the Wapo Ball, you know that New Year that they celebrate is in recognition of Mother Hathor. Did you know that? Oh, yes it is. Let's bring it back to that reality. Let's bring it out. Let's bring the power and the glory of our women out. You women who are raising these young ladies, teach them to be feminine. Teach them to be wise, not cunning and manipulative. That's what society teaches people. In order to survive, you must manipulate. Don't teach them that. You follow me? Teach them how to be women. Teach them to be goddess. Teach them to be proud, but not boastful. Not ego-tripping. Kind, but not so kind as to give away everything that a family needs. But extremely wise. A wise woman outweighs a man with understanding. You know that? But if you sisters have been sitting back and letting it be us, Dr. Ben, Dr. Khalid, Dr. Jeffrey, Dr. Malachi Ziyok, Minister Farrakhan, Reverend Ike, you know what I mean? Yahweh Ben Yahweh. What else? Sweet Daddy Grace, Clarence 13, 36 of Summer X. Malcolm X, Dr. Martin Luther King, not Queen. Well, Father Divine, the Prophet, Noble Drew Ali, the Honorable Messenger, Elijah Muhammad. Campos, Biso Campos. How long we could go on, Marcus Moses, Garvey, Haile Selassie, the great Lion of Judah, the Emperor, the Emperor. That wasn't a joke, that was a mistake. You with me? Who? Mandela. Imagine what his wife went through. I think, brothers, if you look at the world, and how long we've been doing it, and how poor of a job we've been doing, if we start letting the woman do it, then there'll be a change.